So, we've built out most of our project and it's looking pretty good. Let's change all of it from a dark design to a light design. But what we'll cover in this lesson is a little different from what we've done before. And to a lot of us, what we're going to cover here is the most exciting type of exercise on a site build. The style panel, everything we've done here, is literally using the same CSS properties you can find on Apple.com or YouTube or Webflow University itself. And we know CSS, cascading style sheets, this is the ability to style HTML elements, like headings and paragraphs and div blocks, and use that style, use a class, on a bunch of different elements. So we'll go through each page's design and make this happen. Homepage, project pages, and contact page. And the big question, why are we covering all this now? Well, usually when we zoom out and look at this stage in a site build, it becomes a valid exercise, not only to see what the light mode would look like in Webflow, in our development environment, but to explore how effectively we've built out our styling. This kind of exercise reveals a lot about the decisions we've made, and it smells like coffee.
What?
Is it site class?
No, from 610th Coffee Roasters.
Sounds like product placement.
So product placement is, if I would say 610th is better than site class, which by the way it is.
Now it sounds like double product placement.
I just said one is better than the other.
Great point. Some people will like dark mode, others will like light mode, others will want something else. And that's the beauty of exploring this. We'll be as flexible as possible with our styling, so you can design almost anything to work best for your portfolio. Let's get started on the homepage. First, let's back up our project in its current form in case we want to revert back to this point. We'll go over to Site Settings, Backups, and we have a number of backups that have been automatically created. Sometimes we'll do this whenever we duplicate this project. Let's create a new backup, Pre-Light Mode, with a hyphen. So, with the backup completed, let's work on the homepage. First thing, we might want to select the body and go to our body all pages tag. And from here, we can set our first light mode variant to the background color. Let's set the background color to FDFDFD. Lots of stuff just became nearly invisible. That's okay. We'll fix it. And we'll go to change the font color, the default font color. And right now it's failing a contrast ratio of 1.02. Terrible. Let's see what happens if we make it black. That's a bit more legible for this heading, but not so much for the text block. Let's see what else we have in body all pages. A lot of this stuff is working right out of the box, but we might want to make some other changes. We'll definitely make some other changes. Let's start at the top and work our way down. We'll press escape, so we're no longer editing the body all pages element. Let's see what we have going on. The text block, this already has a color set right here. Let's go in and change it to black, and it's keeping that opacity, that 70% opacity, with still a very decent contrast ratio. Before we go much further, let's work on our navbar. A black navbar on white looks fine. Let's try to really go full light mode and change this, double-clicking to edit the symbol, and we'll go down and add a white background color, a pure white background color. And before we start replacing or styling these things differently, something to note about editing light mode and dark mode like this, it sometimes helps to change the background color to a gray or an intermediate color so we can see both white and black against the darker or lighter variant. Let's select Megan Garcia Portfolio. And this is an image element itself. If we go into the cog, we can see it's logo.svg. We have a dark variant. Let's go to the Assets panel and we'll drag in from off-screen dark logo.svg. And if we click the cog, replace image, let's replace it with the dark variant. So that's one element down. Let's go to projects. And right here we can select a font color that more appropriately matches our lighter background. Let's choose black. And now that we have that contrast established, we can go back and select our navbar and make its background color white. Almost done, but there's one more thing. This kind of button variant up here on the nav link button variant, has a white background color with 20% opacity. Let's just flip that to black. Doesn't look great. Let's try our brand color and then change our font color to white. That's good for now. Let's go back to our instance, press escape to deselect everything. This area is looking pretty good. We're gonna come back to this hero section in the next lesson to make a fully interactive 3D, well, 2D and 3D interaction. But for now, let's continue down. Right here we have a paragraph style. Let's make that font color black, so we can see it has an okay contrast ratio. Perhaps drag that up so it's AAA rated. That looks a lot better. Let's go in here. Now, here's a great point about inheritance. This font color right here is being inherited from our body all pages tag. In fact, we can go in and select our font color, and we can see it's coming from body all pages. So How do we take care of that without having to go in each individual element to change its font color? Well, we can select any of its parents. In this case, we might want to select the collection list itself and change its default typography color to white. And just like that, we solved all of our font color issues. So all of these look great in the collection list. We'll check tablet, mobile landscape, and mobile portrait in just a moment, but for now, let's continue down. The gray on white, it looks okay. It still has an appropriate contrast ratio, black against the gray background, but we could try something else here now that we have a light variant. Let's double click to edit our contact form. And for our form block, let's change this color to pure white. And let's add a soft drop shadow. Let's go down to box shadow. Let's set our blur to something like 150 pixels. And we'll drop the opacity to something like 10%. And we'll set the distance for now to 0. Let's press escape so we can visualize this. That looks good. We can do better. Let's double click. Let's go back down and edit our outer shadow. We're going to set the angle to about 135. And we'll increase the distance to, let's hold on, option, let's do 40 pixels. And let's increase that color a little bit. Let's do 15 on the alpha. That looks a lot better. And with that, we might be done with our home. Oh no, that's one more change we have to make on the footer itself. Let's select the footer, double click, and change the default font color there to white. Let's scroll to the top, make sure we didn't miss anything else. There may not be enough differentiation between the nav bar and the section underneath. So let's add a little box shadow, say 100, maybe 75, with a color of not that much. It's a little more of a lift. Let's check our other breakpoints. The menu bar is not going to look great. Double click, menu button. Let's change its color to white. That looks better. And once we've changed that, let's go to our element settings panel and open up our menu just to make sure we can visualize everything inside. Let's go back to the style panel and we'll change the background color here to white. That looks better. Let's change our nav link button. Same thing here. Let's make it white and maybe change the color to black. And when we're done, let's leave this instance. Enter preview mode. Let's press this to test it out. It looks pretty good. Press again to close. Let's leave preview mode. So let's move on to mobile landscape. Still looking pretty good here. Mobile portrait. And of course, our larger breakpoint, 1920. Things are looking fine on all of these. Again, if things look a little smaller, especially if we're in a smaller window or on a smaller display, that is, of course, again, because things are scaling down to 76.7% to fit that full 1920 pixel width inside our canvas. That's one page down. Let's do four more with our project pages. So we'll go from the home page to our projects template. Now, here's where we can get in trouble. We need to always reset back to the base breakpoint whenever we're doing any major style changes. Again, styles cascade from our base breakpoint down towards smaller devices. They also cascade up towards larger devices. So we have to make sure we're editing our base breakpoint to start. Now, there are some hidden things on this page. We can go into body, again, use that same technique and set our body all pages tag to something that's not FD, FD, FD for right now, just to kind of see some of that stuff. Let's make it gray. Then we'll go back in and change this. Let's change this from a light color to a dark color. And we'll continue down. Let's select project info, same deal here. Dark color, project description. Again, we know we have to unbind. So we're gonna uncheck get text from the project details. We'll go in to the paragraph and we're now affecting all paragraphs when nested inside of project description. Same deal here. Let's change the color to the darker variant. When we're done, let's select project description and rebind it. We're going to relink it to our project details. Looks pretty good. And with our project link, we might want to do something a little bit different. We might want to change the background color here to black and make it more of a button. So let's add padding on all sides. Let's say 10 pixels of padding. And we can add some rounding. Let's add a radius of 5 pixels. And maybe the background color could be our brand color. Again, we're going to have a design review in just a few lessons. Let's leave this the way it is for now, and we'll come back to it a little bit later. Scrolling down, we have each of these images, other projects. We're seeing a darker color here. Let's do the same thing we did before. Let's select our collection list wrapper and change its default color to white. Now, why isn't that passing down to our darker text? Let's undo that change, Command Z or Control Z on Windows. Let's select UX Design and let's see where it's getting that color from. Let's press the amber indicator. That's coming from Project Info. So this is our first really great example of something a little messy going on. This is coming from a style we got way up here, Project Info, and we changed that to a darker color. This isn't too complicated because if we go back down here, we see we have the other combo class, so it's Project Info Other. So we can change its font color, do this to white. It's still failing, so let's increase that opacity against these different background colors. Let's do maybe 86, gets us double A for right now. Let's click out, scroll back up, validate that we haven't changed anything here, and Project Info has maintained its integrity. That looks pretty good. So, all done. No, let's change the body all pages tag one more time to white, or FD, FD, FD. And let's validate. Scroll down, looking pretty good. Looks great on desktop. Let's go down to tablet. Tablet's looking fine. Looks great. Let's go down to mobile landscape. Works fine on mobile landscape. And finally, mobile portrait. And before we forget, let's go to our larger breakpoint. Check there as well. That's five pages down because math. Let's move on to our final, our contact page. Up to pages, let's go down to contact. And so far, let's make sure we switch back to our base breakpoint. So far, this looks okay. Of course, we're bringing in that styling. We're bringing in that styling from another page for two reasons. One, we're using classes, but two, this is a symbol. So a change on any instance of this symbol. When we change the symbol once, it affects all pages that use this form block, that use our symbol, the contact form. One thing to note, this contrast ratio may not be high enough. Let's go into our secondary brand color. It's failing at 1.74. Let's try our main brand color, and that's AAA rated. Let's leave that there. And finally, let's do a quick check. Tablet, looks good. Mobile landscape, mobile portrait, and IMAX. So we just redesigned or reimagined a lot of our styles on our homepage, on our project pages, all four of them, and of course, on our contact page. Lots of custom design work coming up as we begin to wrap up, revise, and even rebuild some of our portfolio to make it as engaging and effective as possible.
Did you want me to print another copy?
I feel like you've been forgetting about me in the recap.
Sorry, Grimmer.
I said that I wanted to remind people to go on Twitter and post on the hashtag 21dayportfolio. And it's important that I share it with everyone after each lesson. And I'm left without a camera operator, which is not cool. But I have an iPhone. It's not updated to iOS 15 like yours. I'll do it in the spring.
Why not?
I had some issues with the storage. It was full. I take a lot of photos and videos. Actually, only 64 gigs. I need to get the 256 next time. But yeah, I'm just letting you know. I'm here to remind people to post.